Goaltenders were there when they needed to be.
Well, they definitely are guys that are going to be dependent on no matter what, Dan. And when you can be steady back there and make sure that your teammates know that you've got their backs behind them, they can afford a couple of those misplays like that. Joel Esperance with a great chance there that he fanned on. Then Tyler Hayden with the backhand. And it looked like the middle of the period, it was really Michigan Tech that came on hard in this one. Smith able to withstand pretty much everything that the Huskies were able to throw at him. Malcolm Gould with a good chance there as he wheeled around the net. But then late in the period, the Bulldogs really started to push back.
Well, both goaltenders have played real well and a lot more chances in that second period, Dave, largely because of the power play opportunities. First, we'll get a look at the freshman, Darren Smith.
Moving so well in the net, not giving anything up on his lateral movement. He's been able to gobble up a lot of those rebounds tonight. Puck's just kind of sticking to him. It's always a good sign for a goaltender. Maybe not necessarily the same for Jamie Phillips with that sticky part, but he's been in the right place at the right time for a lot of these saves as Michigan Tech kept taking penalties. Boy, so many chances for the Bulldogs in there. Breakaways, shots off the post, shots off the other post, but still nothing able to get past the senior netminder. He kind of lost his form, but got the glove up there, kicked it up in the air with his leg, got it off of the top. It's a great play by Ferris. It's exactly the chance you want. Jamie Phillips just that little bit better, getting just enough of that to send it over the top of the net. Wow. But Bruce Horst right now one win away from being tied for all-time wins at Michigan Tech as Jamie Phillips sits one victory behind it.
Back at the point of drive and a score! Bobinski! He wires one in and it's a 1-0 Bulldog lead!
Not a lot of traffic in front in there, but boy, Bobinski leaned into that shot. Walked in from the top of the point and he just let that thing go. Amazed the net even held it by the time it got there. Maybe a little bit of traffic and even a tip coming through there. I think it might have gone off the stick of Max Ballas and deflected. Let's take one more look as the Huskies tried to block it. That thing changed direction on the inside. Jamie Phillips left with no chance as he moved left to right.
He's a guy who likes to engage up ice offensively, now down by a goal. We'll see that happen more often. Watson plays that. Look at where it ends up. It's on top of the net. Darren Smith just reaching back up over his back like, hey, I got that. No problem.
I think it hit him. Coming through there from the corner. Cliff Watson into the corner, just throwing it in front of the net. It made a hit up the top of his mask. That could have gone anywhere at that point. Darren Smith had no clue where that puck was. Watson just a little soft backhand, hit the defenseman's stick, and then off the crown of the helmet of Smith.